Hello everyone, welcome back to the Thomas Gallery, and today we have the skull of the Capuchin Monkey, aka the monkey from Friends, aka the monkey from Ace Ventura Pet Detective. Every little small monkey you see in Hollywood shows or movies or something like that usually is a Capuchin monkey. Very, very small, well-known primate. And it is a monkey. It is a primate. It has a tail. It's a primate with a tail, so it makes it a monkey. And I think other than chimps and gorillas, the Capuchin monkey is like the most famous ape there is outside of human beings. And for many reasons. One, they're small, which lends itself to being very adorable and able to have a certain mischief to it, which is why when usually a Capuchin monkey is in films, they usually put the monkey in, like, you know, very, very precarious positions where, like, you know, very mischievous. Oh, I forgot the scientific name is Cebus Capuchinus. Cebus Capuchinus. And the other species of Capuchin monkey. The other species of Capuchin monkey. So called have different names, but for this particular one, I chose that. And why did I choose the Capuchin monkey? Well, for the same reason I chose the other animals. You know, I didn't want someone to watch the video and like, oh, well, you drew the same skull. It's the same thing. You know, a baboon skull, which I drew earlier, and a Capuchin skull are not the same. Shoot, they don't even look well. They look. There are a lot of other skulls that look more closely to that than the other. So, and if you look, that's why I got quiet, concentrating. Like, there, a Capuchin monkey is about the size of, like, a house cat. If I were to give it a size, about the size of a cat, a house cat. You know, long tails, very small head, so. Which lends itself to, excuse me, living atop of trees, living in trees, you know. They're small, they can maneuver very fast, nimble creatures. Also, another show I forgot, the Big Bang Theory has a Capuchin monkey in it. I know for years, if I'm not mistaken, for a lot of the shows and the movies, They used to use the same kind of the same Capuchin monkey. Like, there was a famous monkey they used to use in Hollywood for those things. I don't know, you know, what happened to the monkey. I don't know if, you know, if it passed away, if they still using the same monkey. I don't really know the life. I don't know the lifespan of a capuchin monkey. But there was a while, like in the 90s, where they used to use the same monkey for like all the movies and all of the TV shows. If I'm not mistaken, I think, correct me if I'm wrong in the comments, which I'm sure you probably will, the same monkey that they used in Friends was the same monkey that was in Ace Ventura Pet Detective. Let me know in the comments section if I'm right about that. Yeah, because they used to be like certain animals they would use in the movies. They use the same dog. They would use the same chimpanzee, you know. But no, for capuchin monkey, I think the same animal that was in Ace Ventura Pet Detective was the same one that was in Friends. Cause remember in Friends, I was named Ross. He had like a monkey. I think it was Ross who had the monkey. I don't know. There was a monkey in there somewhere. I ain't seen the show in so long. I forgot. There was a monkey in there somewhere. I stayed up all night doing drawings. I couldn't go to sleep, so I was drawing. Working on my secret drawings and stuff. And I didn't go to sleep till maybe 5-6 in the morning. I already had this prepared, but I just couldn't sleep, so I was just up standing up and drawing. I was on Instagram Live and stuff drawing. Sometimes, as an artist, you just can't sleep. Could be, you know, just the spark of inspiration. You know, just could be, you know, just a lot of your mind. Which I do have a lot on my mind, and spark of inspiration. So that's a double whammy right there. Excuse me. So I had a lot on my mind, which makes it very difficult for me to draw. And I was inspired at the same time. So I needed to find a way to use my energy properly. Had to use my energy properly. Let's see. I'm not going to say it yet. Those famous words always say, but I never actually asked if I should barely do it. Let's see. I was up listening to Jill Scott's album last night. Really got a chance to really, you know, dig into the album and really just analyze it. The first three songs, I was like, wow. I mean, I knew the album was good. I bought the album when it first came out. But, you know how when you listen, you it's music you do like, but you go back on it. You go back to it years later to listen to it again with different ears and a different perspective. You like, man, this album was better. It's better now than it is then. it was a bomb album. Look at that, man. Jill Scott. I wish you would come back out with another album. Jill Scott, if you listen to this, please do me a favor and put out another album. Like, please. We need you. Like, seriously. If you don't mind. If you got the time and you don't mind. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Thank you, Julie from Philly. Peace, love, and all that good stuff. Yeah. Let's see. Is that all? A couple of things. Not too much. Don't go too crazy, Chris. All right. Now I am done. Thank you all very much for watching and listening to this video. Excuse me. Leave a comment down below. Like, comment, subscribe, and share. Also, check out my second channel. Ouch. C. Thomas Talk. That's C. Thomas Talk. All capital letters. I already have a video up. My second video introduction. Go ahead and check that out. I'll put that in the description box. And I will catch you all later. Peace.